It is indeed my great pleasure to welcome my dear patients and their families. And million thanks for giving life to this book. I really mean it. You have given the life to this book. My dear patients, you have taught me more than what my books have. And the cancer has taught me more than life has. An young 24-year-old man walks in and says, "Sir, I just started my job and my career. I have to take care of my parents. There is no one to take care of them. If I die, they would die. Please do something. I have to live." The treatment is done and is happily living with his wife, married and having children, and is taking care of his parents. An young 14-year-old girl walks into my clinic with her widowed mother. "Doctor, uncle, everyone in the family are crying. Am I going to die? Is there no treatment for me?" My eyes were welled with tears. She has gone through the toughest treatment that anybody at that age group can go through, and she has become victorious. She is now pursuing her fashion designing. There are several such emotional, touching, powerful stories, and I can go on, which were felt throughout my career. The moral is, the minute they hear the news that they have cancer, immediate thought in their mind is nothing but death. They start losing the battle before they actually begin to fight. I thought there should be some way to deal with this fear from cancer. Fear from the diagnosis of cancer, fear from the treatment of cancer, fear from not getting rid of the disease. So when a doctor tells a patient that everything would be fine, it doesn't appeal to the patient in total. But when it comes from a patient who has gone through this journey successfully, it will work wonders. It certainly makes a significant impact on the newly diagnosed patients. It prepares them well. They see a hope, start thinking positive, and fight with vigor. Keeping this in mind, I started talking to my patients who were visiting. And normally the answer is often no, but most of my patients were kind and brave enough to share their stories. Within 6 months, we could collect these stories and shaped into a book, I Am a Survivor. I Am a Survivor shares powerful voices and stories of hope and inspiration. I Am a Survivor exemplifies the cancer survivors of human race, their journey, and their demonstration of flawless endurance. It covers stories of several extraordinary cancer survivors who live their lives with the same intensity as others. To honor what they stand for and offer their tale as an example for those walking the same path, the reader is given a rare opportunity to join the courageous and heartfelt journeys of so many cancer patients as they transform into incredible, strong cancer survivors. I feel this book would immensely help the newly diagnosed cancer patients to fight the battle with hope and courage. It's going to be a nourishment for the soul. Cancer is devastating, but what cancer cannot do, it cannot cripple love, it cannot shatter hope, it cannot corrode faith, it cannot silence courage, it cannot invade the soul, it cannot steal eternal life, it cannot conquer the spirit. Say it loud and read on. I am a survivor. Thank you very much.